What's up, guys? Chaos here, bringing you guys another video. Today I'm bringing you guys a great gameplay. It's salary cap. Haven't given you guys a salary cap game in a little while. And it's against my guy, Don't Care About Ice, aka George. He's a great player this year, man. He's been the two-time Jets Club Series winner. He was number one on the LCQ leaderboards this last time around, which everyone good was playing on because it was the last tournament. He was number one with a crazy good record. He was like 110, something like that. So another great game against him. And I hope you guys are going to enjoy it. It's really a back-and-forth game. It comes down to the wire, and we're both really good on offense. We get a couple stops here and there, but it's really an offensive battle. That's how this game is. I hope you guys are ready for it. If you guys are new, make sure you guys hit the sub button. If you guys aren't new and you guys have been rocking with me for a little bit, make sure you guys hit that notification button. Make sure you never miss a video. And if you guys could, I'd really appreciate if you guys would continue to hit the like button. You guys have been killing it for me. And if we get 150 likes on this video, I'll bring you guys another gameplay, man. I hope you guys are ready. Let's get it. All right, boys. We're playing my guy, George. As I mentioned, you guys see the teams. We're going to both have really good teams just the way salary cap works this year. He's got Lamar. I got Vic. We both have Odell and Julio. We're going to have great teams. It's just the way it works, like I said. It's so, so hard to get a stop this year. So whether you have good defense or bad defense, you need to make sure you stacked your offense in order to make sure you score every single time. Because if you don't keep up and score, you're going to struggle. And now, something that you just saw on the first play, he did the reverse crosser. Something you're going to see pretty much all game, Lamar throws a terrible ball there, is he's going to do that reverse crosser a lot. And I'm going to give it to him. I wanted to test something a lot of the game. And what it was that I was testing was when they go to that high ball crosser, they're actually going to go out of bounds most of the time. What prevented them from going out of bounds is when they get into that ad catch straight up animation and your guy goes for like the hit stick tackle. So when that happens, it's going to keep him in bounds. So what I was trying to do was I was trying to grab onto my defender, and instead of going to a knockout animation, try to tackle him, try to pick it, anything like that, I was trying to pull my guy away. And you're going to see me do that later on down the road. But early on in the game, I was not doing that. And as you can see, he caught the first two balls. I'm going to start messing around with it later on in the game. And you're going to see it. He's going to get that a lot. And the way you take that away, just so I could get it out the way early, a deep quarter will take it away. But I didn't want to have to deep quarter that side all the time. So I wanted to see if I could stop it with a cloud. And that was my way of doing it, was trying to pull him away. So just letting you guys get that out the way early. He had a great first drive. Only incompletion that I remember was a bad ball by Lamar Jackson. So good job by him. We have to go answer. Like I said, it's hard to get stops on defense, so you need to make sure you have a great offense to make sure that you're able to score every time. Right here, we hit our zig route, and Randy Moss drops us. So not a great start for us. Third and 10 here. We got to just make sure we keep chucking away, keep chucking away. We hit our post across the middle. Nice little laser for Odell right there. This was a little bit earlier when I used to have Elite Route Specialist. I just recently, very, very recently, got rid of Elite Route Specialist because of smoke screens. I love smoke screens, and you lose them when you put Elite Route Specialist out there. So that's my reasoning for that. But Elite Route Specialist is still good. If you don't have any use for the smoke screens, the Elite Route Specialist is still great for sure. Right there, I probably had my crosser, but as I always preach, man, if you have your open drag, don't wait on your crosser. You never know if you're going to get block shed. You never know if a blitz is going to come through. You never know what may happen. So I try not to wait on routes to develop unless I know I can sit there and I won't get sacked. But it's hard to know, especially with the way sheds happen this year. So I didn't force it right there. I just took my free 10 yards. We have set up for three. Not the best scenario, but we're going to try to get a stop on defense. And if we can get a stop right here, we'll be all right. But we definitely can't give up seven. If we do, we're going to be in some trouble. Right here, we play perfect defense, get a lot of block sheds. He ends up shedding the sack, but we end up getting the second sack just because everything was locked up downfield. He didn't have really anything open. Right there, tough break on a third and 14. I did not think that was open. He got a perfect animation, not only to catch it, but to get out in space and rack it, even though I didn't feel it was open. So tough break there for us. And then right there, he just throws an absolute laser to get down inside the five. So, tough break. We try to get stingy down here. That's our best chance, but just can't do it. He punches in and we're down 14-3. You already think right here, this is a tough spot for me. But it's not the end of the world. It's not. You obviously don't want to give up seven right there to go down two possessions, but it is our ball at half, number one. Number two, if we, it's like the end of the half, so we can clock this out. If we can clock it out and make this the last drive of the half and either get 3 or 7, we'll make it a 4-point game with our ball at half, or at least a 1-possession game with our ball at half. So that's the goal right now, is just try to make that happen. And if we're able to do that, we'll be okay. But it's not the best scenario for us. We didn't start this game the way that we wanted to. But we can make this drive work. We're driving well, and we're taking some clock. So that's all you really need to do. And right there, we thought we had him possibly deep, but we just throw it up. No one else can catch it but Odell. Move on to the next play. Not the worst scenario right there. I thought I had him deep. I didn't think he was going to be able to pick it, so I can live with it. But right there, our elite route specialist post. It was tough for me to get rid of that post, man. It really was. It's a really, really good post, but I have some with smoke screens. The way the meta is playing right now, I really want to have that smoke screen. So I can live without that post, but that post is very, very, very good. It's tough to lurk both the crosser and that post, so it worked out well for me, but we ended up getting rid of it. That's okay. And right here, we play some big boy football as well. He agged us crazy with a reverse crosser earlier in the game, but we got him right there. And it's always nice to get a little payback ag. If they're going to ag you, let me ag him too. Don't knock out my ags when he's catching his ags, you know? That's part of the problem with this game is that, yeah, you'll catch ags most of the time. That's cool. But when your opponent's catching them and you're dropping yours, you start to be like, all right, this is getting out of control. It's fine when as we play great defense right there and scream at him. It's fine when you're both catching ags. Now, it's still aggravating a little bit, but it's not the end of the world. But it really starts to be the end of the world when they're catching them and you're not. So it was nice to get that ag right there. And now we're trying to pick up a big chunk. If we can get 3 right here and make this a 1-point game before halftime, we're in prime shape to win this game. To be down 14-3 and be in a position to possibly make it 14-13 with our ball at half, that's perfect. Especially just because we were playing like so, like we were playing bad defense, but then we weren't getting sevens to answer them. So those are the type of games you usually lose. If you're getting threes and you're not stopping them, you're probably going to lose. But we figured it out. We got a key stop to give us a 3 right here. We got a 7, and now we're down 1 our ball at half. And we're in position to take this lead, and we're going to be in full control. So that just shows how quick a game can really flip with just one drive and one stop. It was 14-3. I got a touchdown and a stop to give myself 3, and we end up taking a big step in this game to making it a lot closer. Right here, we hit our corner route, get our feet down, and we're moving the ball now. We're starting to move the ball. We're passing the ball well. We're 11-15. That's not bad. I'll take it, especially with the way we started. I'm pretty sure we dropped 2 passes on our first drive, so definitely not bad whatsoever. And right here, we're just going to throw the ball away. I always preach. It's something I used to be a lot better at. Actually, I've gotten worse. I've gotten greedier. There's nothing wrong with throwing the ball away and or taking a sack as opposed to throwing a pick. Throwing a pick is like the worst thing you can do. So I try to, I think they call that a catch. This game is funny. I just had to talk about that. But here's what I was trying to say. If you throw a pick, you lose your possession. If you take a sack or throw the ball away, like you just move to the next down. So that's probably one of the biggest skills that I've learned in this game. But I also digress from it just because having a fast quarterback. When I had a slower quarterback, I was better at like not forcing anything. But I'll run around with my quarterback and do something stupid now. But it's definitely something that I've tried to learn just because if you force balls, it's just bad things happen, guys. Bad things happen. That's all I'm trying to say. Throw the ball away. Take the sack. Don't throw picks. All right. I know I rambled for a second there, but we settled for 3. We took the lead by 2. Not the most ideal. We wanted to get 7 there, but coming from where we were, it's a great, great thing because when you get a stop and a pick, you're in prime position. So what I was going to say was you obviously want to get 7 on that first drive at a half, but you're okay with 3 because you want to take the lead. You don't want to walk away with no points on that drive from halftime. You lose momentum. So we take our 3, and guess what? We get another stop. We get a pick that puts us inside the 10. So now what I'm thinking is 7 pretty much ends this game. If we get 7, we go up 9, and the game is cooked. So this is an important drive, but it's not looking great for us right now, boys, because it's 3rd and goal from the 8, which is almost impossible to score if they play good defense, which he does, and we take a sack. So we have to settle for 3. Now, that wasn't the ideal situation. Obviously, you want to get 7 on one of these drives. You don't want to settle for 3 twice. However, that is why you settle for 3, because you don't. If I go for it on that 3rd and 1 and don't get it, I'm still down, and then the game changes completely. The scenarios are so different. And now that I did go take my three, I got my stop, I took another three. Now we're up 5 points, and we're in a really good position to win the game. Even if he goes down and gets seven, we're still in prime position to win this game. So that's why it was so important to take your points, especially against like a top player like him. He's one of the best players all year, as I already said. So definitely want to do that whenever you get an opportunity to take your three. Definitely want to take it. Right here, we played pretty good defense, but we just couldn't fit it in because he was able to get out. That little left pocket, a lot of times when you don't blitz, that left pocket opens up on the 3-2-5 defense. He was able to roll out and hit his corner route. So good play by him. Right here, he hits his reverse crosser. And right there, that was what made me think of what I was talking about earlier with his crosser. When they go to that reverse crosser, they'll go out of bounds a lot of the time. So if you don't hit them and bring them back in bounds, they don't complete it. So that's what I was talking about earlier when I was trying to pull my guy away. And obviously this is a cut video, so I don't incorporate the incompletions all the time on there, but he definitely incompleted them a few times with me pulling the guy away and not letting them catch it. But that was also part of me being stubborn and not wanting to deep quarter my guy over there. That time he did catch it. He gets his seven, and he's going to go for two to go up to three. Obviously, you have to go for two here because it's the fourth quarter, and you want to make it a full field goal. You don't want it to be a one-point game. But we got our stop. Now, this is what I talked about before with taking your points. I took my points twice. At a halftime, I took my points. I got my stop that I wanted, and then I got my points again from my stop, and I didn't take seven on either one, but I was able to get some type of points, and with that, I was able to put myself in a position now where I am down one on a game-winning drive. If I just take the whole clock and take my three, the game's over, and there's only like 3 minutes left, so this is an easy clock. I just have to make sure I consistently move the ball, consistently move the chains, and not take sacks like that, but it's a perfect position for me. If I had a choice of what I would rather be in, offense or defense right here, down one, 100% of the time I'm picking offense. 100% of the time, just because it's so easy to go down and get three in this game. All I have to do is clock him out. And right there, he sells out to the run. Pretty sure he ran commit. We get 9 yards. Love to see that. Absolutely love to see it. Next play, we run a dive. Another first down. That pretty much does it now. Clockwise, he would have about 10 seconds if I don't get another first down. So I'm not going to knee, but I'm going to run the ball just to take a few seconds with me at every play. And then with the last play, we would ideally give him about 5 to 10 seconds, which I'm cool with. He can have his 5 to 10 seconds. You're not going to get 3 with that with no timeouts. And he knows that. So as you can see, we're kicking it with about 9 seconds. Holding it a little bit, making sure he doesn't block. And this is something that I always do. I don't want to ever let it get down to three, but I'm also not going to just kick it right away. So try to do it somewhere in between. Just before they try to time it up, just try to guess. Obviously, it's not a foolproof plan, but it's about the best you can do if you don't get a perfect kick. So two seconds left here. I'm just running my man at three deep. And that's going to do it, guys. I hope you guys enjoyed. He's a top player this year. Great, great player. He was Jets Club Series 2 years in a row. And he's been very close to breaking out like a huge major run in tournaments. He just didn't get it done. He was number one on the LCQ leaderboards this last time around. So hope you guys enjoyed it, man. If you did, like, comment, subscribe, and take it easy. Peace.